This is what Seabrookville looked like, and this photograph was probably taken in the winter between 1913 and 1914, because there was a trial, and a lot of these are trial exhibits. And the Putridge boarding house, I believe was this one right here, on the right-hand side, number 17. And these are boarding houses. And it's interesting to see them, because if you go to Seabrookville today, one or two of these are still there, and they look like that. But a lot of them have been modified, some of them have been knocked down, and there actually are some that aren't, didn't start out this way. But you can see that these are obviously the boom, 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 this cookie cutter, just the same houses, all of them. Those are boarding houses. Those are all owned by the mining, and the mining would rent these homes out. And a lot of people, to make money, would then sublet beds or rooms in the house to workers. So the Putridge boarding house, there was a husband and wife, they had a couple kids, and they'd taken in 8 or 9 boarders, more men who worked in the mines, who all spoke Croatian. And that was one of the common themes you see, is there'd be a Finnish boarding house, or a Croatian boarding house, or an Italian boarding house. And we know from testimony that the Croatian boarding house in the Putridges, next door on one side was the Italian boarding house. The other side they called the Hungarian boarding house. And then across the street was the Finnish boarding house. And I'm sure there's others. I've looked at the census records from 1910 and 1920. And you'll actually see some of these guys will be in one of these homes in one census, and they'll be 3 doors down in another census. But they all stay in this general area. And it's probably all based on the language you speak and how well you get along with the boarding boss and, you know, where your friends live and so on. But a lot of these men also were single men. Caitlin and Syndicate both come here, and their wives are back in the old country. And I assume they were going to save up some money to where they either get their own house or send the money back home or bring their wife over or whatever. In the meantime, if you went upstairs in the Putridge boarding house, and I see photographs of it, there's nothing but beds jammed in there. And, you know, it's a bedroom like almost like you have like a submarine or something where just, you know, people just as tightly as you can jam them in to sleep. So Ivan, Caitlin, Ivan Simic had gone to the home. They'd eaten their dinner when the 6 men show up to come and get them. And this is from the other side of the house here. And there's an alley right here. And you can see this telephone and gallows looking thing. It has something to do, and I apologize, I've never had anybody explain it to you, but there's some kind of bowling game that is a challenge we're playing, but it wasn't bocce ball, because it also involved bowling pins. And they're playing a game in the side yard, and this whole event takes place in the summertime, right after dinner time. And it's beautiful weather out, it's hot out, and so you couldn't pick an event to have more witnesses for. So, you know, notice there's a little fence there. There are 5 or 6 men in the side yard playing the bowling game when the 6 men show up, along with Quick. So Quick and 6 men. The 6 men have got guns drawn, and they approach the fence, and Thomas Brawley, who's not on the path, turns to Quick and says, "Is one of the men here?" And Quick recognizes Caitlin and says, "Yeah, that's Caitlin right there." And Brawley yells at him and says, "You, come with me." And Caitlin, whose English is not that good, says something back to the effect of, "No, I won't go," or "No, I won't come." "No, just no, I won't go with you." At that point, all 6 men jump the fence. Maybe 5 men, but a bunch of them jump the fence with their guns drawn, and they grab Caitlin and start beating him up. And I'd like to point out to people that the moment they jumped the fence, they were trespassing. That becomes very important here. Of course, the minute they started beating him about the face and head with the butts of their guns, they're also assaulting and battering him. And when they tried dragging him away, they were attempting to kidnap him. But that's a little bit ahead of the game here. So they start beating him. Now, the problem, of course, is you've got 5 men who jump the fence and are beating this guy, and all of his friends and relatives and neighbors are standing around. Now, none of